नमस्कार, आई एम आनंद एंड यू आर वॉचिंग जॉइन फॉर एडुकेशन। लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट सेक्शन सी ग्रामर क्लास 10। टेस्ट टाइप इंक्लूड्स समेटिव असेसमेंट 1 एंड समेटिव असेसमेंट 2 इंक्लूड्स गैप फिलिंग, सेंटेंस कंप्लीशन, डायलॉग कंप्लीशन, सेंटेंस रीऑर्डरिंग, एडिटिंग, ओमिशन, सेंटेंस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, एक्टिव एंड पैसिव वॉइस, न्यूज पेपर हेडलाइंस, प्रेस्क्राइब सिलेबस of this section is determiners, tenses, subject verb agreement, non-finites, relatives, connectors, conditionals, comparison, avoiding repetition, nominalization, modals, active and passive, reported speech and preposition. Let's study about one by one essence of grammar. In this section, first of all, we try to understand determiners. So the first question of this section is a very simple question: what are determiners? If anybody asks us, what do you mean by determiners, then the answer of this question will be: determiners are the words which are used before nouns to determine or fix their meaning. If we want to fix the meaning, then we use determine before nouns. There are following types of determiners, which are as follow: articles. So articles is a kind of determiners. A and the are the articles. Demonstrative adjectives is also is a kind of determiners. These, that, these, those are the demonstrative adjective. Possessives: my, our, your, his, her, its, their. With the help of these words, we express possessives. Adjectives: quantity and numbers, some, any, much, many, all, both, little, few, several, less, one, two, etc. With the help of these words, we express quantity and number, and these words are known as adjectives. Others: each, every, next, another, either, first, second, etc. Let's discuss about this one. Additional information: noun. There are two types of noun, countable and uncountable. There are two types of countable noun: singular and plural. These are the example of the uncountable noun. Oil, water, furniture. It means that oil is not counted, water is not counted, furniture is also not counted, or the word or noun which are not counted is said to be the uncountable, whereas the noun which are counted is called non as or said to be the countable noun. Articles. It means that there are two types of articles, indefinite and definite. A and an are the indefinite articles, whereas the is the definite articles. Indefinite articles, a and, used before singular countable nouns, represents a class or kind in general. Let's see the example. A cow give us milk. Here the meaning of a cow will be every cow. Hope that there is no problem to understand these explanation or details. Let's see. A used before singular countable nouns beginning with consonant sounds. There are some examples. A one-eyed man, a unique place. If we see here that U is the vowel but the sound is consonant, therefore we used here A. If we consider about one, then O is the vowel, whereas the sound of one is consonant, therefore we used here A. In some textbook or grammar, or there is confusion, before vowel we use A and before consonant we use A, and before vowel we use N. So according to, due to this confusion, here we started to N, and this is not correct. Let's see. N is used before singular countable nouns beginning with vowel sounds. So if we consider about an Indian, then Indian is the vowel sound, and our is the vowel sound, therefore we used here at and so on. Hope that there is no problem to understand the use of A and N, which are indefinite articles. Let's see the definite articles. The used before both countable and uncountable nouns. Let's see the usage or usage of the definite article the. When we talk about something for second time in the same context, or anything qualified by a phrase. Let's see here. I meet a girl at the gate of the school. The girl, it means that girl is used next time, and according to the rules and regulation, here we use the. First time reference, the book which is on the table is mine. It is a kind of phrase. So these are the simple details about section C or grammar section of class 10. My next video lecture will be related to the next topic of this section. Thank you very much to stay with me till the last details of the articles. Hope that these details will be useful to the students who are studying in class 10 and the audience who are interested in English grammar. If you think that this is the useful to the students of class 10, then please do share this video lecture to other students of your surrounding. Once again, I thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.